So this is the question that the Lord is proposing to you, right? This is Psalms chapter 90, chapter 94 and verse 16. Mm-hmm. Who will rise up for me against the evildoers?
So when you stand up for the Lord today, brother, today is your day, brother. Today is your day. The Lord is calling you to stand up for him. Will you stand up for the Lord today, brother? All right, come on.
Who will... who will stand up for me against the workers of iniquity?
And who will stand up for me against the workers of iniquity? So now the day is your day, brother. You need to actually turn to the Lord in fear and sincerity.
Just we don't play. In the dark, we walking like the children of the day. Listen, Sakari, boy, I bleed this shit. Tell them crackers, I bleed the fifth. Bring that fire like Prometheus. I ain't tripping off that measly shit. Dub, I keep the fifth.
For blessed is the one whereby righteousness comes.
Hold on, read this part again. It said what?
For blessed is the one whereby righteousness cometh.
Y'all think y'all gonna be blessed because y'all worship this man. Well, actually, y'all curse.
That's right. Right.
Y'all curse because y'all go around and y'all worship good, sweet, white Jesus.
Right.
Right. Won't he do it?
Yes,
right.
He will.
Right. Won't he give my mom section 8? Right. Right. Won't he do it? Right. Won't he bring mommy and daddy back together? No, he the reason why they separated.
That's right.
Go and look up your history. Come on.
But that which is made with hands is cursed as well it. As he has made it.
Right, as that which is made with hands is cursed as well as he that made it. So the person that made all these images is cursed as well as the damn image. Come on.
That's right. He, because he made it.
Right, that person because he wanted to sculpt it. Come on.
And it, because being corruptible, it was called God.
Right, because they want to go around and they want to call one of the damn Beach Boys the Messiah. Right? How the hell is a homosexual gonna be the chosen man, right? Right, the chosen man to lead the righteous people, right? Ain't nothing righteous about somebody that has sex with his sister,
right?
There's nothing righteous about that, man, right? And he actually killed his brother because his brother was against it, right? Come on.
For the ungodly and his ungodliness are both alike hateful unto God.
Right, so y'all both are like hateful to the Most High God. Get Leviticus 20 and 26.
You got it, keep reading.
For that which is made shall be punished together with him that made it.
So both of these images is going to be punished together, right? These images are going to be punished together with him that made it.
Right, you're my brother, bro. I just asked you a question.
Two questions, bro.
I was going to ask you your nationality, bro. Because I'm only worried. Ask
you. Right.
All praise, man. Man, my man from Canada, he Colombian. I want to ask you something, bro. Who would you consider this as? Who would this be on this image? This is how people betray Jesus. So how would Jesus look like?
Yeah, man. He didn't look like this for sure. So bro, what I want to tell you is that get Zephaniah, bro. One of y'all, 2 and 1. Just 2 and 1. I just want to read this one scripture to you. Because the thing is that blacks and Hispanics, we beef and we war with each other, but at the same time, we have the same enemy, right?
No,
this is the enemy. The same people that afflicted you afflicted us. So now we have to come back together. This is what the Bible says. Read 2 and 1.
This is the book of Zephaniah, chapter 2 and verse 1. Gather yourselves together.
What?
Gather yourselves together.
So the Bible says that blacks and Spanish got to gather together. It's not talking about everybody in the world. So we have to gather together, bro. Come on.
Yeah. Gather together, O nation.
No, all races.
O nation.
No, everybody.
O nation.
Everybody that love Jesus.
O nation.
So the Bible says gather together just one nation. Why? Because they divided. A person came around and separated one nation. So the Lord said, gather together, O nation, not desire. Come on.
O nation, not desire.
Not desire. Why are we not desire? We're not desire because we're better than everybody.
Right.
That's why everybody hates, right? Jeremiah 12 and 6, right? This is why we're not desire, because everybody hates us. And the Lord says, come together, because why? Everybody else hates us, so why shouldn't we love each other? If that makes sense, bro. Like why should I go and rob another black man? He already low and in poverty just like me, right? Why shouldn't I try to go and work with him? right? But instead, we don't do that. We go around and we hate each other, and all we do is we feed more of the beast, right? This damn white man. So read what you got, 12 and 6.
God, this is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 12 and verse 6. For even thy brethren and the house of thy father. Mine heritage is like unto me. It's unto me as a speckled bird.
So God said that his inheritance is like a speckled bird, right? A beautiful bird, right? We're a beautiful people. Nobody look like our women. This is why everybody desire our women, right? But they don't want to marry them, right? That's a problem that our women need to understand. Keep reading.
God, it's unto me like a speckled bird. Birds on the bone are against her.
Right, so everybody hates her. Right, every other nation around us hated. Go back to Leviticus. Keep reading the wisdom of Solomon.
For that, Solomon, it's the book of wisdom of Solomon, chapter 14, verse 10. For that which is made shall be punished together with him that made it.
Right, both of them is going to be destroyed. Right, this damn image and the damn white man who made it. Right, come on.
Therefore, even upon the idols of the Gentiles shall there be a visitation.
Even upon the idols of the Gentiles, there shall be a visitation, right? Hold that, get Ezekiel. Ezekiel 20 and 32. Read what you got, 20 and 26.
This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 20 and verse 26. And ye shall be holy unto me.
No, we should be niggas.
Ye shall be holy unto me.
No, just be spits.
Ye shall be holy unto me.
So the Lord said we should be holy unto him, come on.
For I, the Lord, am holy.
The Most High God is holy, come on.
And have severed you.
No, brought you together.
Have severed you.
Right, the Most High God said he severed us. Right, he cut us off like an arm, right, from a body. He said he severed us, come on.
From other people.
We don't belong to any other race, man. We are our own entity. Right, we are our own people, man. We are our own race, right, bro? Bro, let me ask you something. What's this right here, bro?
Be careful.
What's your race? Puerto Rican. So who came over here with this image? Because originally when the Native Americans and Spanish was already on the island, they didn't have this image. So who came over here with this image? Portraying this to be the Son of God. This is portrayed to be the Son of God around the world. Who did this? What, was it Chinese people that did it? It was white people, right? So these is the criminals that did it. And if you look, this is the actual man that it was. This is the actual man, and then this is the actual image. Now drop down. Now go to Wisdom of Solomon where it says that the artist is, the auto price is 19.
This is
14, 19? Yeah, 14, 19.
This is the book of Wisdom of Solomon.
It's like 18.
Chapter 14 and verse 18. Also, the singular diligence of the artificer.
Right. So what happened was Michelangelo and Leonardo had a competition on who could paint him better. And Leonardo won.
I agree.
And Leonardo.
I never think that was that white man in the picture.
So this was a stumbling block for people. And don't you believe in the Bible?
Yes.
So this is what the Bible says. Read that part again.
Also, the singular diligence of the artificer.
Also, the singular diligence of the artificer, right? The artist, Michelangelo and Leonardo, was both white people. So they painted another white man, and Leonardo won. And guess what? He was actually Leonardo's lover. He actually had man sex with Leonardo. This shit is weird. Come on.
Did help to set forward the ignorant to more superstition.
And it helped to set us forth to more. We was ignorant. Right, we came over here and we trust them, right? So-called Spanish and Native Americans, y'all have a loving heart. But guess what? Now we got to turn back to loving our people, right? And what's wrong with that? Blacks and Spanish is the same people. So according to the Bible, you'll be from the tribe of Ephraim, right? Right. So you're a special person. And guess what? That's actually a special tribe because y'all would be the kids.
right? Colombians, so-called Mexicans, right? So y'all can be the head. That's why y'all gotta be an example, man. Just like the so-called blacks in America gotta be an example, y'all gotta be an example too, right? To help turn our people back to the Lord.
Right.
Don't you wanna turn to the Lord? Let me get Psalms 94:16. Right? Don't you believe that you're serving the Lord, right?
No, I'm not serving him.
But so what?
My mother is a Christian. I wouldn't believe that
the picture
according to, you know, what they believe. But I always feel him in that territory in Jerusalem. You know, we were in there and I believe we were
in just like you have a level of melody. When actually this so-called white person, because he's not actually white, he's actually red, right? He doesn't have melanin, or he has a very low level of melanin, right? So what he did was he lied, and he called the Native Americans redskins, when actually he just pictures the Native Americans with afros and very dark skin. Some Native Americans way darker than me, right? So here's you guys. So this is the question that the Lord is proposing to you, right?
This is Psalms chapter 94 and verse 16. Who will rise up for me against the evildoers?
So when you stand up for the Lord today, brother, today is your day, brother. Today is your day. The Lord is calling you to stand up for him. Will you stand up for the Lord today, brother? All right, come on.
Who will... who will stand up for me against the workers of iniquity?
And who will stand up for me against the workers of iniquity? So now the day is your day, brother. You need to actually turn to the Lord in fear and sincerity. Why? Because it's a whole lot of traps out there. Right? That's a trap out there. This is why we need to turn to the Lord and gather ourselves together with our own people. Like we just read to the brother who was Colombian. Right? We need to come together. Right? Because the Lord is not coming back for a multi-ethnic group. He's all... You don't believe that? How do you understand that?
He died for everybody.
He died for everybody?
He died for everybody.
Let's get Matthew 15:24. Let's just read the Bible. You believe in the Bible. You said your mom. So what had you go straight from believing Christianity? What had you go straight from Christianity?
Learning a little bit about the Bible. Or I used to sit there with her and I read something about the Bible.
So you never really truly turned away, you just stopped going to church?
No, I never, because serving God is a decision that you have to obey the law.
Right.
It's law.
Right.
And I never been ready for that.
Oh, you never been ready to
no.
Well, today is your day, brother. Today is your day, because why? The Lord actually is calling you, right? So the whole thing is that, will you hearken, right? Will you hearken to the voice that's coming out now? So read what you got, Matthew 15:24.
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 15 and verse 24. But he answered and said,
who's the he right there? It's the Messiah. It's who the world called Jesus Christ. But he answered and said to a non-Israelite, because you know Jesus was an Israelite, right? So he said to a non-Israelite, come on.
I am not sent.
He said, I, me, myself, I am not sent. Come on.
But,
except, right? Except only, come on.
Unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
So why don't they teach that in the church? Because that's what the Messiah said. The Messiah said he's only sent to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
This is the book of Acts, chapter 5, and verse 29. Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God rather than men.
No, I'm going to listen to my homeboy.
We ought to obey God rather than men.
This is what we ought to do. We ought to obey the Most High God rather than men.
The word.
And the God of our fathers.
The God of our fathers. Why is it making all these, saying all these pronouns, right? All these personal words. The God of our fathers, come on.
Raised up Jesus, whom ye slew and hanged on a tree. Him had Yahweh exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior, for to give repentance to Israel.
To give repentance to the whole world.
To Israel.
And that's it. That's all he came to give repentance.
That's right.
Right? It's Israel. Why? Because what does salvation mean? Get Luke. Get Luke 1 and 68. We just gonna give you the definition because the Bible, people actually don't understand this. But the Bible is similar to a dictionary book. Right? It's not just giving you these words and these concepts that you have to come up with yourself. They're giving you a word, salvation, and then you go into the book, and then it's giving you the definition, the biblical definition of what salvation is.
Right.
Read 68.
It's the book of Luke, chapter 1 and verse 68. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
Blessed be the Lord God of who?
Of Israel.
27.
For he had visited and redeemed his people.
No, he gonna visit and redeem the world.
His people.
Why is it saying that, brother? Like, it's saying that because it's true. And actually, man took the book, which actually belonged to a group of people, and they took it and they made a religion. Because, why? Let me ask you this. Why I can be any religion in the world. If you want to go there, but this is not a religion book. It's actually laws, statutes, and commandments. Right? It's do what I say. Right? And that's all it is. It has nothing to do with religion. Man made it about religion, but it's actually do what I say. Come on.
And have risen up a horn of salvation for us.
For the world.
For us.
Why do they keep saying this? For us.
That's
we. Come on.
In the house of his servant David. And he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been since the world began.
So now you're going to find out the real reason why Jesus came, right? Come on.
That we should be saved from our enemies.
That's why Jesus came. Because they knew this back then. It's like, look, the Messiah was born. And this is actually who you would call, like, this is actually John's father, right? Jesus, you know, John was cousins with Jesus. So this is John's father. So he has an understanding, and the angel came to him. He says, so we can be saved from who?
From our enemies.
They need to be saved from their enemies. Who was their enemies at the time? The Romans. They were paying taxes to the Romans. So they wanted to be saved from their enemies, come on.
And from the hand of all that hate us.
So who was the Romans back then? How did the Romans look like? Caesar Augustus, right? How did they look like? They were white people, right? They looked similar to this image.
Yeah.
So now you said you believe that the Messiah was melanin, so his people had to be melanated. So now we understand that this is a melanated group of people being oppressed by people that like melanin. So who are we being oppressed by today? Hispanics and black people. Who are we being oppressed by? So now we still need to be saved from the hand of our enemies. So guess what? If we get saved and they get saved, then we will still get oppressed again. No, we have to get saved from them because these are our oppressors, right? They already are saved because being saved means to be delivered from the hand of your enemy.
Right.
To be in rulership. So read this real quick because we're going to hammer it home. And this is what reference that is. That's a good thing. Come on.
This is the book of Joel, chapter 2, and verse 27. And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel.
And you shall know that I'm in the midst of Israel. Israel is a group of people. It's not a whole world.
Okay? Right.
You shall know that I'm in the midst of Israel. Come on.
And that I am the Lord, your power.
No, and that I'm not. So read that. And I'm the Lord what?
Your God.
And I'm the Lord, your God. Not the whole world. Come on.
And none else.
No, but the time is going to come in.
None else.
No, but white people be bad.
None else.
So why he say that? He said, I'm only your God and nobody else.
Right.
Right, so why is he saying that? The reason why it's being said is because this is actually the way it is. And actually people take it and they go and they create theologians and their own theists out of it. But we actually have to take the word for what it is and not what's in our heart. Right? The word says that he is the God of Israel, right? And that's it. So we actually have to see who we are and who we belong to. Right?
This is the book of Romans chapter 11 and verse 26. And so all Israel shall be saved, as it is written, there shall come out of Zion a deliverer, and shall turn away ungodliness from Jacob.
Jacob was a man.
So everybody doesn't come from the line of Jacob.
That's right.
So he said that
okay,
I'm
going
to turn my righteousness
from that
particular
man
right now. Right. So again, brother, we got the information. This is our elder. This is our elder. So you see his number. His number on there.
That's my
and
number.
He got right up here.
Any questions, call it.
Thank you.
All right.
Appreciate it. Peace, brother. Shalom.
But enough pressure, you could turn a coal into a diamond. I ain't crying. I used to be blinded, but now I'm conscious. Waking up in bondage, not knowing about the promise. Now I'm out here in these streets trying to turn my people from violence. Cause this is gonna be a time where this whole place get demolished.